Hello friends, my name is Akash and in this video, I am going to talk about a very common fallacy called as appeal to pity. I will be talking about what the appeal to pity is and why it's a fallacy. Then I will talk about where it is found or used and I will be explaining this by giving examples about it, which will help you to find this fallacy around you. In this video, I'll be also talking about what this fallacy commonly gets mistaken with other fallacies. And at last, how to identify and avoid this fallacy in our daily communication and arguments. So guys, appeal to pity. What does the fallacy appeal to pity means? First of all, pity means sympathy or mercy. This fallacy encourages a sense of pity and creates a feeling of sorry for that person. It is used to make your argument claim being accepted. It will create a condition which will bend you to accept the argument. It will focus on the condition to change it if the party or the person is not agreeing on it. So, it's very simple that if we find any person in a bad situation or a pitiable situation, we are ought to help him. So, we naturally feel pity for him. And we like to do something for him. And this will make us believing in their claims. Because we are feeling pity on him or her. And now, why it's a fallacy? Because it never provides good evidences for the claims and arguments. It just tries to convince you by causing feeling of sorry or guilt. And no clear grounds and evidences make it a fallacy. It is not that people expressing their bad condition and asking for pity are always lying. They may be saying the truth, but it can be justified. Appeal to pity is used where a person is really in a pitiable or bad condition. But it can be also used where the pitiable condition is just imaginary or fake, which does even not exist, and this makes it a fallacy. Appeal to pity is used everywhere and every day around us, from school to colleges, to judicial system and government of our country. Nowadays, it is very much used on the social media also. We can see number of examples of appeal to pity around us. I will like to give some examples on it. For example, if a student comes late to the class and appeals that he or she is late because he don't have a private vehicle and he travels from a long distance. So, he have to change two or three buses to reach here. By this, he tries to convince the teacher by explaining his pitiable condition so that the teacher would allow her or him to sit or enter the class. When we go out, we come across many beggars who ask for money by saying different pitiable conditions, like they do not have food, they do not have shelter, or there is a harsh climate outside, and so on. But we don't really know why they do or what they do with the money and whether their claims are right or wrong. Even in the judicial system, appeal to pity is used when a lawyer says that his client in terms of when a lawyer tries to protect his client in terms of age, gender or any disability. For example, my lord, how can we punish a 70-year-old man? What will be his condition at this age? Or in terms of gender, my lord, if the lady will be imprisoned, not only her life, but whole family's life will be ruined. Think about her daughter. Think about her son. No one will marry there. Who will make their life better or their living will be affected? We can give example of a social media also. Nowadays, we come across many images. Your one like is equal to one pray for the cancer patient. And if you don't like this picture, you don't have any mercy for the patient. So please help them by giving like. How can we believe such examples? Because they don't have any claims or any evidences whether they are saying the truth or false. I would like to give some more examples. Imagine a candidate for an interview. He may claim that he should get this job because if he doesn't get this job, then he may lose his house. We can take an example of a student for convincing his teacher to make him pass in the examination as he claims that he worked very hard for these. Even he was sick and there was nobody at home. Then also he tried to complete his all tasks. And if he is failing in this exam, then his grade will come down. So please pass me in the examination. So the teacher may feel some pity on him and she will give some marks to pass him. But we cannot believe all these claims. Imagine a beggar coming with two or three children with her and asking that we have not eaten for many days, we have nothing to wear, at least look at these children, give something by looking at their face. We cannot believe them just by hearing their claims because they are not justified. We don't know where the money goes or for where they are using the money. So we should look at all the factors related to it.
Of the appeal to pity, and like all fallacies of relevance, the appeal to pity is trying to distract you from the main point of the argument, in this case by making you feel sorry for the person who's arguing. Now, an appeal to pity is also known as argumentum ad misericordiam, and it's using feelings of sympathy or pity to make someone accept your position. Let's take a look at some examples. So, you should find me not guilty. If I go to jail, my children will starve. Therefore, you should find me not guilty. This argument isn't telling us anything about the person's guilt. It's just telling us that some bad things will happen if the person ends up going to jail. However, if our job is to find the truth of whether or not they are guilty, such facts have no bearing on the case. You should hire me. If I don't, I may get kicked out of my house and become homeless. Therefore, you should hire me. This is not telling us anything about the person's qualifications for the job. In fact, if anything, it's probably telling us that they are so unorganized or in such trouble that they're about to get kicked out of their house. So if anything, we shouldn't hire them. And you should convert to Judaism. If you don't, your mother will be sad. Therefore, you should convert to Judaism. Someone else's feelings don't bear on truth of an argument. So it's not something that is going to be valid. It's going to commit the fallacy of the appeal to pity.
Now, there must be a question that how to find this fallacy. To find this fallacy, first you must notice that there will be a pitiable or bad condition. The person will state a condition where you will feel guilty or pity for him. But you should not directly believe his claims. Because first you should find evidences or clear grounds whether the person is saying correct or not. For this, you should look for evidences about his claims. You should look for broader context. You should see that are you responsible to correct it, or you should see that whether the person who is claiming it, whether he is responsible to create it. You should not directly believe and see other factors too. Now I would like to say that this fallacy also gets mistaken with other fallacies or other elements. And I would like to say by an example. For example, a student argues with the teacher that he or she should be excused for being absent as he was injured in the accident. But this can be justified by his or her reasoning. But if a student claims that he should get 10 on 10 on this project or any project because he worked very hard, he worked for 20 hours, so he should get 10 on 10. But the working hours may not show the quality of work he did. So this is not the proper justification of now. How to avoid making the fallacy of appeal to pity? First of all, avoid yourself from being emotional to such fake stories or such fake claims. Research the situation to determine who really does need help or protection. Who does deserve compensation? What kind? How much? And why? See if you can provide better claims or better ground to that claims. Don't just blindly believe the claims that are made to you. You should find out that who really is responsible for the situation that are made, or are you really responsible to the situation that are wrong and you should correct it? Distinguish who bears the responsibility to assist or protect others and who does not. Simply believing to claims and simply believing to the fake stories will not help you to find out the fallacy and the justification which are correct. An appeal to pity is a fallacy in which a person substitutes a claim intended to create pity for the evidence in an argument. Formally, we can present it in this way. P stands for pity, C stands for claim. This line of reasoning is fallacious because appeal to pity will not have any evidence for the claim. It can be clarified by an example or an illogical example. You must accept that 2 plus 2 is 5. And after all, I am dying. While you may pity me because I am dying, it will prove that my claim is true. Just because something is said doesn't mean that it is more or less true. But not all uses of an appeal to pity are fallacious. There may be examples where an appeal to pity is closely connected to the subjects of the argument or is the actual evidence for the acceptance of the claim. An appeal to pity attempts to persuade using emotion, especially sympathy rather than evidence. This is highly effective and so quite common fallacy. This type of argument is a fallacious because our emotions responses are not always good guide to truth. We should base our beliefs upon reason rather than emotion if we want our beliefs to be true. Watching my video, if you found my examples disturbing, then I'm really sorry, but I was not trying to hurt anyone. And if you liked my video, please add a like or comment to it. This video is a part of my project. The motto of this video is not to offend anyone. The examples used in the video are just used for the purpose of explanation. Thank you guys. Thank you so much.